We're going to start lying down on our backs. I would love for you to take your feet as wide as your mat, with your knees bent, and let your feet or your knees fall towards each other. So fall in bridge. Bring one hand to your belly, one hand to your chest. Let your elbows be heavy, your shoulders be heavy. And breathe. And just notice your state of being. Just be observant for a moment. Just trying to get us 2 extra minutes of contemplation here. So yeah, for 2 minutes, I'm gonna try to keep my mouth shut for a bit. I just want you to breathe. Breathe into your body. Start to feel that union of breath and body dancing together. And when the breath and body have this union, then the mind is this kind of focused rhythm that supports. It doesn't become chatter or loud. It's the harmony of our life. And it's not in the past, it's not in the present, not in the future, it's in the present. Just breathe on that for a bit. Hi, Cindy. Hi, Nina. We're just starting lying down, fallen bridge, knees together, breathing. If you've got a strap and block handy, great. If not, don't worry. What's the quality of your breath here in this shape? Notice the length of the inhale to the exhale. Where do you feel the action? In your belly, your chest? Maybe you feel it on the back body. Maybe it's in your throat. Maybe your nose, because the mask kind of allows the air to conjure in there. There's no right or wrong. There's just you being observant. And when we're observant without judgment or labeling, then we can find that space of gratitude. We can put ourselves in a place of opportunity. And that can all stem from just breathing into the body. Because what is the breath? It's the connection to prana. It's the connection to the energy, the molecules, the atoms, the DNA, the light that we don't see that puts us on this planet. It is magic. So just another moment here, and the idea is we want to invite this harmony between the breath and the body, the rhythm of the mind staying focused into the moment and what you're doing to be this practice. Do we live in this perfect world? No, there's gonna be times where you don't understand what I'm saying, or like something becomes hard, you hit a wall. All these little things are gonna kind of start to throw themselves at you through the practice. And how you react is really the wisdom that we can pull in, right? Do you overreact and judge and say, why did I come today? I'm not, I'm tight, and create these stories and huff and puff? Or do you go, oh, this is challenging. Or I don't get this movement. Or I have to look around and see what's going on. Right? The perspective of how you move and practice is really the essence of yoga. It's connection. You can take that with a grain of salt. You can hold it to your heart. You can ignore it and just be here for yourself, because that's who you're here for. I'm just a tour guide. Just to help you maybe open a door that might be covered. Shine light on a window that might be blocked out. We work together. We should all be grateful for that. Good. One more deep breath in here. I want you to hold at the top. Exhale completely. Feel the emptiness. Bring in the pattern, the rhythm of breath to move your body. In a toe heel, your feet in. Stretch the legs forward. Reach the arms overhead. Love this stretch. Get long. Feel the muscles hug. Don't worry about any alignment points. I want you to decompress. All right? Life is decompressing. Some of us feel very compressed around the holidays. We've got so much to do. Hey, this practice is gonna help you make space, not only physically, but can we make space emotionally for stuff that's coming in to process? Good. Knees are gonna hug into the chest. Give them a nice little squeeze for a moment. We're gonna get deep into the belly. All right, so you're gonna keep your knees in. Take your arms out into a T, palms facing down. I want you to flex your feet as much as you can, keep your inner thighs together. If they don't wanna stay together totally, don't stress too much. I want you to hug the knees in as tight as you can, like the thighs are starting to massage the belly. You're gonna roll slightly to the right hip. Don't let the knees go to the floor. Squeeze the knees in a little closer to the right armpit. Keep that left shoulder blade down. Breathe. Stay here for three. So don't go so far over that you're struggling. Right? Just start to feel a gentle shift. We'll get deeper as we go. Right? I'm a big fan of working progressionally. Right? That way we're not forced to go too deep. Draw the knees back to center. Right, hug them in. Exhale, little tilt to the left. Squeeze the knees in nice and tight. Right, if you've gone over to left and you feel that right shoulder blade really lift, then you've gone too far. But just hold. Start to feel contraction. Right. Good. Inhale, bring it back to center. And then nice deep inhale. Exhale, you'll go to the right, maybe a little deeper, as we're not going to hold this time. Inhale, squeeze the ankles, shins together, come back up to center. Exhale to the left. Inhale to center. One more, just like this, and then potentially adding on. Exhale to the right. Inhale, center. Exhale to the left. Inhale, center. So you can stay just like this. I want you to honor your back. You're gonna inhale or exhale to the right and then squeeze the legs straight out. Good, bend the knees, hug them in tight as you come back to center. And if that feels way too much on your low back, just stay with the knees bent, right? We're just getting warmed up. You don't have to prove anything. But if when you lengthen out, you're like, oh yeah, a little more oblique work. Good, bend the knees to come back to center. Option to do that again. Otherwise, we're gonna take it up even one more notch and then you get to play. Right? We're gonna go over to the side. So right side, straighten out the legs, keep the legs straight. squeeze back to center. Legs stay straight. Exhale, bend. Take it to the left. Inhale, straight. Lift all the way back to center. Right. Now this, if you want to stay with the legs straight, you've got 5 more rounds on each side. I've just given you 3 different options of play. Shoulders stay pinned. That's pretty much the only kind of anchoring I would like you to stay. It doesn't matter if the legs are bent or they bend and straighten or they stay straight, right? You have the anchor of the shoulders, the arms, the palms. And we're finding this rotation, right? Massaging in the ascending colon, the descending colon, the kidneys, the adrenal glands, the stomach, spleen and liver, everything else that's in this core area. I like the creaks and cracks as long as there's no pain along with them. That's just air leaving the joints. When you've done 5 on each side, just bring your feet down, hands to the belly, breathe. Just take a moment and just allow yourself to kind of sit in that work. Especially, we're gonna go into the flow. We live in this momentum society where something's always starting before something's always finishing. So just have these moments, especially when you do some intense kind of core work, just to feel the effects, the blood flow, the heat, come back to the rhythm of the breath. Good. One more time, reach the legs straight. We got one more little quick stress here, or stretch here. Straight up to the sky, that's awesome. Now lower them all the way to the ground. There you go. That's a little bonus core work for you. Reach the arms overhead, just like we did at the beginning, big stretch. And I want you to feel that stretch in the belly, in the side waist. Good, exhale, knees hug in to the chest. We're gonna use our strap. Right knee stays in, left leg goes long. You're gonna find your strap. If you don't have it, I'll come bring it to you. Strap will go around the sole of the right foot. Right foot's gonna go up to the ceiling, left leg out along the floor. Breathe, get into the hamstring. Now, what I'd like you to do is put both ends of the strap into your left hand. And I want you to take your right thumb and put it in your right hip crease. Okay, but switch legs just so we're all on the same page. There you go. Not wrong, just the other leg. Good. So I want you to press that right hip crease towards the front of the room. Take a nice deep inhale. And just bring your right leg over to the left, just an inch. Don't let your right hip come off the ground. Come back to center, right? And play back and forth. So exhale, go over. I want you to get really deep into the IT band right here. And after about 5 times moving in and out, take that right leg all the way, or just over, press the right hip back, and then slowly, slowly keep that right hip moving away from your right armpit. Come all the way over into the full stretch. Stretch that left heel towards the front of the room and open up the right arm. Breathe. Open up through across the chest. Now see if you can reach that left arm towards your right foot. So get that left arm active too. Right arm out to the right, right? Just reach your left arm closer to your right foot. Left hand closer to your right foot. Up the strap, Julie. There you go. If I say it about 20 different times, one of them's going to catch, right? It's all perspective. It's not me, it's not you, it's just the world. Good. One more deep breath. Go into like that twist in the back. And I want you to remember how this feels right now. Okay? Your body's going to. It's in there at a cellular level. Good. You can bend the right knee, bring it back to center. Your hips may have shifted, so I want you to take the strap off, hug both knees in. Make sure you feel your hips come back to neutral. When you're ready, we're not gonna quickly, but we're gonna efficiently do it on the other side so we can get into our flow. Left foot goes up. Take a moment with the hamstring stretch. You'll put the strap in your right hand. Now, if you reach that right arm up now, the work is done. Left thumb, you're gonna adjust yourself. I want you to take the left thumb right in the hip crease. Deep breath in, exhale, push your left hip towards my voice, towards the front of the room. And then gently take the left leg just an inch or two to the right. It's this very intrinsic movement. And sometimes we feel like these extravagant big poses, that's how we get more out of yoga. Sometimes it's the little refined stuff. And if you can keep your attention in that kind of narrow work, minutia work. And we want to experience it all. We want to experience the little tight movements and then the extravagant movements. So nice deep inhale. You know, you'll slowly keep the low belly engaged as you bring the left leg all the way over to the right. Reach the left arm out. Low belly draws in. Try to keep that left shoulder blade on the ground. Muscles hugging to the bone. Yes. Three, two, one. Good. Bend the knee, hug through the low belly, come back up to center. Good. Remove the strap. Give your knees a nice little hug and rock back and forth. Yeah, we're gonna come all the way up to seated. Swing your legs around. Find yourself in an extended child's pose. Have your block at the top of the mat. Strap we probably won't need. Gonna reach the arms forward. I want you to literally look at your hands. We're going into down dog next, right? Adho Mukha Svanasana. So set yourself up for that. Right? The hands are ready. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, you melt. Right? Child's pose if you need to chill. Take off your mask for a moment. This is your spot. Right? If it doesn't feel like your spot, you can find another. Feel the arms start to broaden. Good. And I want you to pull your Of your exhale, step or hop your feet forward. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, fold. Good. From here, bend your knees quite a lot. Reach the arms forward, come into chair pose. Good. Push to rise. Hands come to the heart. Tadasana. Feel the feet on the ground. All 10 toes can wiggle. The kneecaps lift, tailbone down. Heart rises, crown up. Press the palms together. Deep breath in, elbows out to the side. So yes, this is a gesture, right? But I want you to feel it today because we're gonna use it. As this broadening across the chest. From here, all I want you to do is keep your hips straight and you're gently going to rotate the upper body to the right. Keep the elbows pressing out to the side, shoulders soft. Draw the left hip back slightly. Take 3, 2, and wring it out the back of the heart. Right, get a little more action in the chest. Come back to center, right? See if you can bring your elbows in line with the wrists. Thumbs right at the sternum. Deep breath in. Exhale. Find the twist in the back of the heart, the thoracic spine, right? The thoracic for most of us is tighter. It's in the mid back. Breathe. Keep the palms pressing into one another, right? And at the same time, can you soften the shoulders? Face. God, come back to center. I'm going to take that full namaskar in slow-mo. Start to push the hands forward and up as you bend the knees. Utkatasana, chair pose. If your shoulders are open enough to take them by the ears, great. Otherwise, come in front of you so you can draw that front rib cage in. Breathe. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, step back to down dog. Add in plank if you'd like. Right, nobody's counting your vinyasas. Chaturanga, half plank. Inhale, up dog, cobra. Right, exhale, down dog. That area in the next 20 minutes becomes the choose your own adventure. Right, but that adventure has to have the connection of the breath and the body moving together so that the mind has something to flow with, not judge, not critique. And from here, your right leg is going to lift. I want you to step your right foot forward, rise in the crescent. If you need more grounding today, that back knee can come down. Otherwise, I'd like you to keep it up. Big breath in. Exhale, you're just gonna fold, reach the arms back. Inhale, press up. Exhale, fold. Inhale up. Exhale, fold. Inhale up. Good, we're gonna take it into the twist. Hands come down on either side of the right foot. Hug the right arm underneath that right thigh. Big breath in. Exhale, open right arm to the sky. Yeah, there we go. Exhale, right arm comes down, hug in. Inhale, open. Exhale, down. Inhale, open. Good, bring the hand down. Step back, plank, chaturanga, or go back to down dog. Up dog. Down dog, three breaths. Left leg's gonna lift. Step the left foot forward. Rise, crescent pose. You can do all this with the back knee down, right? So if you're wobbly, whatever. Good, big breath in. Exhale, bow, sweep the arms back. I want you to start to feel that rotation in the shoulder. Inhale, push through the left heel to rise. Exhale, if you feel like you're on a tightrope or you're gripping, take that left foot to the left a bit. Inhale, rise. Exhale. Good, inhale, rise to set up for the twist. Hands come down on either side. Bring that left arm underneath, hug first. Big breath in, exhale, open. Good, in and out two more times. Open. Open. Good, hand comes down. Step back, take the vinyasa. Here we go. Inhale, look to the top of your mat. Step or hop forward. Halfway up. Exhale, fold. Bend the knees, chair pose. Nothing's changing. Well, we might have a few little shifts, but we're going to take it into the flow. Exhale, fold. And all we're doing is bringing heat, vibration, and energy in the body. Halfway up. Exhale, step back to down dog or plank chaturanga. Up dog. Exhale, down dog. Right leg lifts. Exhale, step the right foot forward. Rise. Exhale, fold. Rise. Open up through the chest as the spine starts to warm up. Exhale. Fold. Good. Hands come down. Right hand hugs underneath. Nice deep inhale. Exhale. Twist. A little different if you want to pull that right hip back. Straighten your right leg. Bend the right knee. Hug underneath. Pull the right hip back. Straighten the right leg as you twist. Bend. And fold. Last one, pull it back. It's like a modified twisting pyramid. Exhale, hand comes down. Right leg pulls back. Down dog or plank. Chaturanga. Breathe. Left leg lifts. Right? It's a dance. Step the left foot forward. The breath brings you up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, up. Feel maybe a more of a back bend. Exhale, fold. Inhale, up. Exhale, fold. Hands come down. Hug that left arm under. Big breath in. Exhale, twist. Maybe straightening that left leg. Woo! Bend and hug. Straighten and open. Bend and hug. There you go. Exhale, take it back. plank chaturanga. I like to do things in odd numbers. This is about to be the completion of two rounds of that namaskar. Five breaths in down dog. And we'll do one more, looking forwards. More body breath than brain, step or hop. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, fold. Come straight into chair, inhale. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway up. Moving meditation, step it back, hop it back. What's your joy? When we meet in down dog, no rush, your pace. Right leg left, step the right leg forward. Ground through the right heel, rise. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, exhale, hands down, hug that right arm under, big breath in, exhale, twist and straighten, hand comes down, twist and straighten, one more time, good, hand comes down, press to pull that right leg back. Stay in your down dog or do your vinyasa. How much heat do you want today? Right? Is the vinyasa serving you? Or is it depleting you? Okay. Last time on the left. It's all you. Left leg left. Step it forward. Heel pushes to rise. Hands float down. Rise, bigger. Exhale. Inhale. Going into the twist, hands come down. Wrap underneath for the inhale. Exhale, twist and straighten. Underneath. Twist and straighten. One more. Good, step it back. Choose your adventure. And what's that adventure doing? It's bringing you back to a neutral breath. Slowly lower your knees. We're gonna come into half dog. So the hips stay over the knees, arms go forward. I want you to lift up like you're doing a cat. Exhale, melt down. Drop the chest. Just play there a couple times. Into the shoulders. We're gonna go for a moment. Good, now I want you to come up into that cat shape. So feel like you're lifted forward, hands in front of the shoulders. Take your right arm over, thread the needle, keep that left arm active, reaching forward. I want you to press that left or the right shoulder, right tricep into the floor and feel like you're trying to roll towards the right. Deep, deep stretch, let the head come down as you look to the left. All right, so we're coming into this thread the needle, but I want you to stay active. Left arm reaching forward, right arm reaching to the left, low belly in. Three, two, one. Press the left hand down, pull that right arm up towards the sky. Open the chest, reach that right arm forward.
Right hand comes down. Cat cow in half dog. Couple reps. Good. We'll take it to the other side. Left hand now is going to move. Left hand's going to come underneath. Right hand presses down. I want you to slowly lower that right shoulder down. Look to the left shoulder down. But keep that left arm pressing into the mat. Do you feel that your back's going to roll to the left? Keep it active, okay? Muscles hugging to the bone. Not a passive stretch. Low belly draws in, outer hip hug in. Right arm reaching forward as you draw the right hip back for 3, 2, 1. Right hand presses down, open up the chest, left arm up to the sky. And then reach it forward, get long. Good, both hands come down. You've got a little bit of cat-cow play here in your half dog. Good, palms press, down dog. Right leg's gonna lift. Exhale, step your right foot forward. Slowly lower your left knee to the ground. Inhale, rise, low lunge. Right thumb to the right hip crease. Left hand reaches up, arch over just for a couple breaths. Start to feel that rib cage open up. Good, take a nice deep inhale. Left elbow to right knee twice, and it's gonna hold on the third time. So big breath in, exhale, elbow to the knee. Push down through the right heel, come back up. Elbow to the knee. Push down. Exhale, elbow to the knee. Hold. Palms come together. Same work we did standing. Hey, you'll put that right elbow up to the sky. Take the chest forward if you'd like. Yep, what comes next? The left knee lifts. Breathe. See if you can lift your heart away from that right thigh. Yes, yes, yes. One more full breath. Now our next transition is to warrior two. So it's big. You got to bring that left heel down. Windmill. Walk the right foot to the middle of the mat. Take your time. Set it up. Open up through the chest. Yeah. Lift the torso straight up. Good. Bend that right knee and really elongate from the inner groin to the inner knee. Feel as though you're hugging that right hip under and left inner thigh presses back, not the left hip. Right. Feel the chest open. Straighten your front leg. Exhale, bring it out to triangle. You've got a block, you can use it. Sometimes to really get the chest open, take your right hand, press it to the inside of the right shin. Right, so if it's just here, it's not doing anything. But if you press, you can wrap that right rib cage up to the sky, soften the left down. 3, 2, 1. Bend the knee, come back up to warrior two. Big breath in. Exhale, windmill the hands down. You can step back to down dog or add in the plank chaturanga. Take your time, use your breath. Allow the body to feel and be felt. Spread the fingers, left leg lifts. Exhale, step the left foot forward. Right knee will come down, rise, low lunge. Left thumb comes here. The idea is this hip always likes to hike up. We're just drawing that hip down to make more space in that right rib cage. Right? We don't want to compress. We want to go long, so reach the belly forward. Elbow touches. Push through the left heel to rise. Right? Feel that root so you can rebound up. In and out twice. Hold on number three. Love the squeeze. Massage the belly. Palms come together. Once you get in there, if you do the next one, it's awesome. Okay? Palms come together, and we want to find that same elbow stacking. Try to get that left elbow up to the sky, shoulders away from the ears. Is it necessary? No. But is it fun to try? Yeah, curl the left right toes under, see if you can lift that right knee off the floor. If the earth wants you to stay closer to it today, it's going to let you know. Sometimes you just got to abide by the energy around you. Constantly changing. Extend your heart forward, slide your shoulders down. I like I say that extend the heart forward and the chins follow. Just the sternum. Good. Big transition to warrior two. Drop the right heel. Adjust the left foot. Open up the chest, right? We kind of want to go into that heel arch alignment. Front belly drawing in. Extend. Lovely. So big breath up. Start to straighten the front leg. Hinge deep at the hips. Exhale. Extend out triangle pose. You can press that left hand in. Left fingertips can come to the outside of the left ankle. That gives you more space to open. Right? We want to open. And see, Tina, what happens if you put your block behind the foot? You get the chest open. It's all different. Sometimes you want to play. If the hand's in front, use it. Last little breath here. Good. Bend the knee. Come back up. Warrior two. Exhale, vinyasa or down dog. Maybe even half dog. You lot look going on. Sometimes just grounding the hands, the feet. All right. Come into child's pose. Take your right arm, thread it underneath your left arm, look that way. Unwind, reach your arms forward. Take a breath there. Look the other way. Left arm comes underneath. Both arms reach forward. Down dog. Step or hop forward, Ardha Uttanasana, halfway up. Exhale, fold. Bend your knees, slowly roll on up. Good. Just pause in Tadasana. We're going to play Parvita Bakasana, right? It's an arm balance, but we're gonna take it in so many steps. You've done all of the pieces of it. So we've got all the ingredients. Now we're kind of stirring it together to try to kind of make the one dish. So big toes come together, heels slightly apart. Have your block handy. I want you to reach the arms up, get long. Draw the arm bones into the shoulder socket, low belly draws in. Lift your heels, hug your ankles in. Love the shakes. And then slowly bend your knees. Squeeze the knees together. Now, knees are important. They got lots going on. They might have a story that does not agree with the story I'm trying to tell you, and that's okay. Bring your hands to your knees. If you need to, you can bring them onto the ground. I just want you to breathe here. From here, I want you to take the block to your right side. You've got three levels. Hug the ankles in. Reach the left arm up and over. Bring that left hand onto the block. Breathe. Now, as you notice, you may notice that left knee wants to go out, doesn't want to be part of this party. I want you to hug it in. Squeeze the ankles together slowly. Try to lift. Squeeze the legs together and take the torso over towards the right. For 3, 2, 1. Slowly come back down. Bring the block into the center. Let your knees come apart. Bow forward. Okay. We want this work to be in the hips and then the back. Not so much the knees. I've got some variations, and if it is about the knees, please let me know. Okay. No sharp, no stabbing there. Bring it back to center. Block will go to the left. Okay. It's basically the buildup. Left hand presses down, lift up, right arm reaches up. Take that right arm up and over. Squeeze the legs together. Keep the knees slightly bent, but feel the belly hollow out. Okay. Knees slightly bent, yeah. Good, come back down. Open up the knees. Let everything release. Belly drops in between. Okay. So you can repeat round one, right? If there's a lot going on and that was intense, stay with it. Otherwise, round two. From here, I want you to walk your right hand way over to the right, and then your left elbow. Try to touch. Press the palms down. And breathe. Squeeze your legs together. Shift your chest forward. See if you can balance your knee on your left elbow. And this is a different way to enter this pose. That's it. You gotta squeeze the legs together, get the butt up, come back down, and rest. Shake out the hands. Questions, comments, or concerns? Was that a good time or what? Let's do the other side. So a lot of times we'll come into twisting crow like this, right? So we came into it a different way. I kept your body forward because for most of us, it's easier. There's also training wheels, but just play with this way. So going to the other side, okay? Right elbow comes forward. It's like you're doing chaturanga. Right, chest forward, bend your elbows. Don't do that. And breathe. Squeeze your knees together. Oh, my other side was tired. And then release. Woo, good job. All right, straighten the legs. Release into a forward fold. And as you do, kind of let any negative ideas of that practice, that shape, release. Turn the palms up, wiggle the fingers. It was just about play. The work was all done prior to trying to get to that peak pose, right? Good, hands can gently come down. If you'd like one last vinyasa, take it back now. The back bend usually feels really good. Or you can just go to down dog. Half dog is always an option, which will give you no weight on your hands. And then we're gonna chill in pigeon. Right knee comes forward. Always take this on the back. I want the knee slightly to the outside of your hip. Curl the left toes under. See if you can reverse to open up the hip a bit and take the weight out of the knee. Start to feel a little bit of the back bend, right? So we think of pigeon as this kind of resting pose. It's actually a very big back bend, right? So we want to open up, stretch out the belly from all that squeezing we did. You've got your block. You can even add that. We'll give you a deeper stretch. Heart lifting away from the belly button. See if you can just kind of soften here for 5 breaths before you go into the resting pigeon. If you wanted to add, you can bend that left knee, reach back. If you have the full Raja Kapotasana, feel free. And then very sweetly, let go, lengthen, and release. A couple more breaths here. We're going to take one more variation in pigeon. To start, you're just going to slowly come on up. If you have any blankets underneath your right hip, take them out. And then I want you to bend your left knee and come to sit completely on your right buttocks. So unfortunately, I got my back towards you, but they can see me. See if you can take that right shin parallel to the front edge of your mat and then slide the left knee in a little bit. Lift through the floor of the pelvis. So now we're in deep hip opening. Your left hand's going to come back. Your right arm's going to go up. Breathe. Good. Slowly bring your right hand down to grab your right foot. And I want you to try to grab your foot. Lift up through your chest. Twist. Look towards the back of the room. Now you can stay here. This is, and if your hips are like talking to you, just stay. Otherwise, maybe start to bend the elbow on that right arm. Kind of nestle into the knee. Like, all right, I got something going here. And then maybe slide that right elbow towards the sole of the foot. Woo! If you're like, what? Then you can slide the elbow into the crook of the knee. And what comes next? Oh, the left hand comes on top. Open up through the chest. Yeah. For those of you that like, I love this, right? So this is, I call like the angry area. I used to cry and get really mad in this pose for many years, right? Because we hold a lot of this stuff in our hips. So notice what comes up. Right? Just 5 more breaths. If you're like, I got to release this. I call it the Louis Vuitton luggage of your life. You can stretch that left leg out, maybe even bring it in that pigeon shape, right? Yeah. Sometimes you touch on it, you're like, that's good. Back I go. Last deep breath. All right, but you got to kind of experience it. You're like, not ready. I'll come back and visit you some other day. And unwind. Whoo. Hug that right heel in. Shift that right leg back. And I want you to shake it. Shake it. Feel it. Shake it, 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 shake it. And then open. Down dog. We'll set ourselves up on the left side. Listen to what this side of the body has to say to you in this moment. We'll take the back bend first. And sometimes we hear the word back bend, we just think it has to be this super grand, intense place. Now, the idea is you can feel the pelvis rooting, but the spine elongating up, right? Trying to work against gravity to find extension. And it all depends. The side might look the exact same as the other side. Hey, maybe it looks totally different. But we want to make sure we're kind of feeding the muscles, the joints, in somewhat a similar way. A deep breath, get the oxygen in. And then sweetly ground your energy for a moment. Slowly make our way up. We're going to bring all of our weight onto the left hip. Slide the right knee up far enough that you can find that parallel between the shin and the front of your mat. Okay, this can come all the way up if you want. Hand comes back, makes space. We're doing a lot of that space. This is kind of the last little bit. Exhale. Start to grab the foot. Elbow comes down. Open up the chest towards the right side of the room. And then just see, where is the journey going to take you? It's a big, it's like a 1 foot space between knee and the sole of the foot. Right? So if that's too much, hey, you bring the elbow back to the knee, but really work the rotation, right? Otherwise, elbow, see if you can get it into the crook of the foot. And one more time, those hands stack. Right elbow up to the sky, open up through your chest. The back leg is all about, huh, what's that feel like? take your breath where the intensity is. Go to it. Don't run away from it. Right? We're conditioned in life to run away from fear, from pain. Sometimes we need to protect ourselves. Other times we need to defeat it. It starts in our body safely in this practice. You are bigger than your fear. You're bigger than your discomfort. You're better than all of it. Exhale, release. Last little down dog. Take that left leg out. Shake it. Shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it. Let it vibrate. Good. From here, you'll walk the feet forward, cross the ankles, sit down, ground. Feet nice and wide, let your head release between your knees, the spine round. The action is done. Now it's the hard part. All you have to do is just be and trust. Lift the gaze, reach the hands forward, slowly roll on back. Maybe one last full body stretch. We've done tons of twisting, but if your body feels like it wants a happy baby, right? Maybe you just want to make up a shape or just grab something because that feels good. And this is prep. This is prep for the most important pose of the thousands of poses that we practice. Because it is the most challenging. Right? That final relaxation, Savasana, it translates into corpse. Are you willing to let go of everything in order to maybe receive or maybe not? Start to release. Legs lengthen out, arms reach out. Kind of move anything away that's touching you that you're not purposefully using. So you have an opportunity to feel like you're so grounded in the muscles and the bones and the joint in that physical practice. But leave space and opportunity to feel lifted and levitated by your energy. By the prana, that life force. Savasana.
deepen your breath.
Wiggle your toes and your fingertips. It's almost like a gift, like you're getting up for the second time today, but in this space, no kind of rush to be anywhere. It's sweet. Start to move the body in appreciation. And the trick is, can you appreciate the body for all of the little joints and muscles that work great? And any of the little aches, the injuries, whether they're chronic or just passing through, can you love them too? These are part of you. Easier said than done. Stretch into the space that you take up. And as you draw your limbs back to your torso, imagine yourself pulling in positive energy that you get to walk with for the rest of the day. If need be, breathe into the body to touch on it again, because it's in there. Roll to your favorite side. Don't even think about it. Just do what comes naturally. Take a couple breaths there. Push yourself gently up to seated. We'll sit up nice and tall. We'll gather a little heat in our palms. Once you get a little heat, open up the palms, nice and soft out to the side. Exhale slowly, bring them back together. Hold an imaginary ball of light in front of you. And again, inhale, open. Right, just kind of making sure the energy around us is clear and present. Good, the next time you inhale is a prep for Om. In that ball, you hold the energy, the peace, the light, the connection to all. May you share it with the rest of the world as a gift with grace and gratitude. Namaste.